Folks, this is all the fruit. I am in the beautiful botanic garden of Heidelberg in Germany. And today I want to try the satin leaf or wild star apple. Well, why is it called satin leaf or wild star apple? As you can see here, when you look at the leaves from the top, they look like pretty much a normal evergreen tropical leaf. Once you turn them around, they look like silk or satin or some of those artificial fabrics which are really shiny. Yeah, they have a really nice coppery to bronze color, which really shines like metal. Chrysophyllum, chrysophyllum, the name refers to the color of the leaves, of course. But if you think the name reminds you of something, there is a close relative of it, the star apple, Chrysophyllum cainito, which grows here right next to it, and which also has this coppery underside of the leaves. This produces considerably bigger fruit, which have a star shape inside the fruit. So don't confuse them with the star fruits. The star fruit looks like a shape of a star from the outside. This looks like a round apple, which is like all colors between white, green, and purplish from the outside. But when you cut it open and do it right, you'll get a star shape. But this tree is too small, it has no fruit. Here the relative, the wild star apple, in contrast, has lots of fruit. I don't know if you can see it. I'm filming right against the sun, but it's hanging full of hundreds and hundreds of fruit, despite not being thicker than my arm. So even this small tree is producing quite a nice amount of fruit. And like the normal star apple, those fruit are edible. Oliviforme means, the shape of an olive. Yeah, the fruit really look a little bit like a ripe olive from the outside. Yeah, when you open them, they still look a little bit like an olive, but also a lot like a star apple. Really nice and tasty. Tastier than the big star apples, actually. With a slight flavor like aronia. This is what the seed looks like. Also looks a lot like an olive seed. But this flavor is quite nice. I like them more than the big star apples. Yeah, really sweet, like a sweet grape. But with a flavor which is like aronia, or like those American Muscatel Muscadine grapes. Quite a nice thing. Or yeah, basically eating a really ripe dessert grape with a little bit of an additional taste. Quite a nice fruit. But they got damaged just by falling to the ground, so I guess the really ripe fruit have no very extended shelf life. That might be the reason I haven't seen them on any market in the tropics yet. Also, they're a little bit too small. I mean, you cannot charge too much per kilo, and what that says, you'll need a lot of work to collect the kilo. But they really a nice, valuable fruit. I mean, if they are so nice and sweet in a greenhouse in Germany, they might be even better in some tropical garden. So folks, don't all concentrate on Chrysophyllum cainito, the normal star apple, but definitely also try Chrysophyllum oliviforme, the much smaller wild star apple. Taste wise, I'm giving it like a 5 stars out of 5. It's just a little bit too small and difficult to transport. Those are like the only downsides of this fruit. Well, folks, this was the super tasty Crozofilo boliviforme from the Caribbean and Florida. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the Botanic Garden of Heidelberg. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.